Sisters of Mercy of the Holy Cross, Ingenball. The Congregation of the Sisters of Mercy of the Holy Cross was founded by Father Theodosius Florentini, OFM Cap, and Blessed Mother Maria Theresa Scherer in Switzerland in the year 1856. It is affiliated to the Third Order Regular of St. Francis of Assisi and is of pontifical right. The foundation took place in Switzerland at a time of upheaval and change. A vast number of people in the industrial nations of Europe had been plunged into poverty and misery with the onset of the Industrial Revolution in Europe. Orphaned and neglected children who roamed the roads were forced to work in factories in inhuman conditions. The sick had no proper care. Industrial workers were exploited. The educational system was badly in need of reform. Proper schooling was available only to a privileged section of society. Into this situation, God called and sent a young capuchin, Father Theodosius, who was gifted with an extraordinary social awareness. It is said of him that he saw in 1 hour what most people never see in their lifetime. He recognized the will of God in the needs of the people of his time and searched tirelessly for means and ways to alleviate their sufferings. He considered education to be the most effective instrument against poverty, ignorance, and hunger. He also wanted sisters to be trained to care for the sick, the disadvantaged, and orphans, to carry out his plans successfully, and to give continuity to his works. He founded a congregation of Sisters of Mercy of the Holy Cross. Mother Maria Theresa, co-foundress and the first superior general, cooperated with the founder in all his attempts at social reform. Like him, she too had boundless trust in God and great courage to take risks. Above all, she was filled with an active love for the poor and suffering. She was the kind of sister the founder looked for. The young community was poor. The sisters felt called to take up works which were not likely to yield profit and to move to places where others would rather not go. The sisters went on begging tours all over Europe to save the institute from financial ruin. Despite the insecurity and the hardships, generous young girls joined in great numbers to give their services in orphanages and houses for the aged and destitute. They nursed the sick both in private homes. They supervised home industries and other welfare schemes. Wherever human need called upon them, the Holy Cross Sisters of Ingenball were ready to offer a helping hand. Thanks to the charismatic leadership of Mother Maria Theresa and the loyalty of her sisters, the Institute kept growing through many a storm from early existence. Holy Cross Sisters in India. The first group of Holy Cross Sisters arrived in India in 1894 to take up at first an orphanage in Bettiah, North Bihar. The sisters' presence in new places made the congregation known among more young women who felt called to religious life. In 1970, the Holy Cross Mission in India was given the status of a province, spreading from Sikkim in the north to Kerala in south, from West Bengal to Maharashtra. This event was like a signal for further expansion and development. A number of new stations were opened in rather quick succession in various parts of India. Moreover, the development in ecclesial and secular life brought new insights, a growing consciousness of the needs of the people, and also a different approach to socio-economic problems. Educational institutions, ranging from pre-primary to teachers' training schools, spread over a number of states. The sick were cared for in the government hospitals and dispensaries, and later in the congregation's own hospitals. The South Province, serving in 21 dioceses of Karnataka, Kerala, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, and Goa, Holy Cross Convent at Davis Road is the provincial house of the province. The source of our charism lies in compassionate love of God, who emptied himself in Christ Jesus even to the point of dying on a cross. Through our charism, we take part in the mission of the church. We attempt to prepare space for the coming of the reign of God, where people are brothers and sisters. Following this charism, we plunge ourselves into risky situations, and it has become an outstanding feature of our congregation to be a prophet among the unwanted, voiceless, poor, illiterate, downtrodden, the sick, and the suffering. A great power of endurance coming from the crucified Lord helps us to hold out in adverse situations and to be loyal, faithful, and persevering. At present, we are engaged in the following ministries. Healthcare. Besides hospitals and dispensaries, medical work is extended through nursing schools, medical insurance schemes for villagers, mobile health services, school health program, serving in government projects, HIV or AIDS care units, palliative care, free medical camps, etc. Education. The sisters are engaged in educational work in all levels, from pre-primary to college level, teachers training, job-oriented vocational courses, women's development projects, etc. Pastoral care. Sisters collaborate with the parish team of their working places in the Ministry of Faith Formation. Social work. Holy Cross sisters are at work among orphans, the aged, the destitute, HIV-affected children, street girls, physically and mentally challenged, trafficked girls and women, prisoners, etc. In collaboration with the government and men of goodwill, the sisters do all what they can to bring about the needed awakening for a new society based on peace, love, and justice. Blessed Sisters. Blessed Mother Maria Teresa Scherer, Foundress of Sisters of Mercy of the Holy Cross. A woman lived her present, which has passed to form a future which is now and tomorrow. She was a woman of deep faith, tremendous courage, daring spirit, and commitment. She led the congregation in the spirit of the gospel. Her courage and deep trust in the Lord in the times of turmoil and struggles were amazing. To her sisters, she was a mother and guide, to the poor and afflicted, a compassionate helper. Blessed Ulrika Nisch of Hegne. Ulrika served as the second sister in the kitchen for 9 years. During her short life, she served in the spirit of the Holy Cross sisters. This unassuming service remained a hallmark at every stage of her life. Christ completely filled her being. The more deeply she became united with Him, the more outgoing was her love. She expressed this when she wrote, "I wish to have a love for everyone, a love that is all things to all people and influences all." Blessed Zenka Shilingova. Sister Zenka felt herself obligated to stand up for the cause of the church. Twice, she assisted in an undercover operation to liberate imprisoned Catholic priests whose life was in danger. She did not lose her inner security of Christ's presence in the midst of pain, for she says, "In suffering, our senses are opened to the will of God." We, the Sisters of Mercy of the Holy Cross Ingenbol, invite you to walk with us into the future. There is room for every generous heart to make life worth living. What is your answer?